ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th Canto, Chapter 7, Text number 3. Prajapate Dagdashishno Prajapate Dagdashishno Bhavatva Ajamukam Shiraha Bhavat अजमुखं शिरः मित्रस्य चक्षुषेक्षेता मित्रस्य चक्षुषेक्षा भागं स्वं बर्हिषो भगः भागं स्वं बर्हिषो भागः। प्रजापति ही ऑफ प्रजापति दक्षा दग्ध शीर्षणः हूज हेड हैज बीन बर्न टू एशेस भवतु लेट देयर बी अजमुखम विद द फेस ऑफ अ गोट शिरः ए हेड मित्रस्य ऑफ मित्र चक्षुषा थ्रू द आईज इच्छेता मे सी भागम शेयर स्वम हिज ओन बर्हिषः ऑफ द सैक्रिफाइस भगः भगा। Translation: Lord Shiva continued, since the head of Daksha has been already burnt to ashes, you will have the head of a goat. The demigod known as Bhaga will be able to see his share of sacrifice through the eyes of Mitra. Text 4. उषा तु यजमानस्य दद्भिर्जक्षतपिष्टभुक् देवाः प्रकृतः सर्वाङ्गा ये मामुच्चेषणं ददुः। द डेमिगॉड उषा विल बी एबल टू च्यू ओनली थ्रू द टीथ ऑफ हिस डिसाइपल्स एंड इफ अलोन ही विल हैव टू सेटिस्फाई हिमसेल्फ बाय ईटिंग डो मेड फ्रॉम chickpea flour. But the demigods who have agreed to give me my share of sacrifice will recover from all their injuries. Purport. The demigod Pusha became dependent on his disciple for chewing. Otherwise he was allowed to swallow only dough made of chickpea flour. Thus his punishment continued. He could not use his teeth for eating, since he had laughed at Lord Shiva, deriding him by showing his teeth. In other words, it was not appropriate for him to have teeth, for he had used them against Lord Shiva. Text 5. Bahubhyam Ashvinaho Pushno हस्ताभ्याम कृतभावः भवन्त्वा अद्वर्यवश्चान्ये वस्तस्मश्रूर्भृगुर्भवेत्। Those who have had their arms cut off will have to work with the arms of Ashwini Kumara, and those whose hands were cut off will have to do their work with the hands of Pusha. The demigods, the priests will also have to act in that manner. As for Bhrigu, he will have the beard from the goat's head purport. Bhrigu Muni, a great supporter of Daksha, was awarded the beard of goat's head, which he substituted for the head of Daksha. It appears from the exchange of Daksha's head that the modern scientific theory that brain substance is a cause of all intelligent work is not valid. The brain substance of Daksha, that of the goat, are different. But Daksha still acted like himself, even though his head was replaced by that of a goat. The conclusion is that it is not the particular consciousness of an individual soul which acts, that it is the particular consciousness of the individual soul which acts. The brain substance is only an instrument which has nothing to do with intelligence, real intelligence. The real intelligence, mind and consciousness are part of the particular individual soul. It will be found in the verses ahead that after Daksha's head was replaced by goat's head, he was as intelligent as he had previously been. He prayed very nicely to satisfy Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu, which is not possible for a goat to do. Therefore, it is definitely concluded that the brain substance is not the center of intelligence, it is the consciousness of a particular soul that works intelligently. The whole movement of Krishna consciousness is to purify the consciousness. It doesn't matter what kind of brain one has, because if he simply transfers his consciousness from matter to Krishna, his life becomes successful. It is confirmed by Lord himself in Bhagavad Gita that anyone who takes up Krishna consciousness achieves the highest perfection of life, regardless of whatever abominable condition of life he may have fallen into. Specifically, anyone in Krishna consciousness goes back to Godhead, back home, on leaving his personal material body. Specifically, anyone in Krishna consciousness goes back to Godhead, back to home, on leaving his present material body. Thus ends the Bhakti Vedanta Purport. Om Ajnanati Vrandasya Jnananjana Chalakya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Namavum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharini निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशधारिणि जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। प्लीज रिपीट द ट्रांसलेशन Off, will have to work with the arms of Ashwini Kumara, and those whose hands were cut off will have to do their work with the hands of Pusha. The priest will also have to act in that manner. And for Bhrigu, he will have the beard from the goat's head. So, whose limbs were all cut off. Some relief was given to them. Daksha's head was completely burnt. So Daksha was given a goat's head. And Bhrigu was given the beard of the goat. And other demigods who were all injured, they were all recovered. Their injury healed. And those who lost their limbs and all, they were given different kinds of blessing that they can act through the hands of Ashwini Kumara, arms of Ashwini Kumara, etc., etc. Here in this purport, Prabhupada is making a very interesting observation. A lot of deductions to be made from this observation. His observation is that the brain substance of Daksha and that of goat are different. But yet Daksha, after getting the goat's head, he acted with all his original abilities. The brain substance is only an instrument anyway. It was found in the verses that it will be found in the verses ahead. That after Daksha's head was replaced by goat's head, he was as intelligent as he had previously been. So, the other day we were giving one example that if you take a soul alone, not with subtle body, pure soul alone, then everything the gross body, subtle body put together will do. That I take my soul out of my body and I go into your body, which is not possible. It's a thought experiment because you cannot separate the chittam from the soul because of the karma. Each of us have our own consciousness, contaminated consciousness. It's a consciousness body, contaminated consciousness.
And that cannot change. That means that cannot be, the soul cannot be separated from that. So in the case of the example that I gave,
concluding from Bhagavad Gita, what Krishna says, the soul is only a kshetrajna, he's a knower of the soul, it's the knower of this kshetra. And all these activities are in the kshetra, including the consciousness activities is in the kshetra. So soul is only the kshetrajna. But we understand from the scriptures that when the living entity comes into this material world, it gets covering of gross body and subtle body, and subtle body consists of chittam, false ego, intelligence, mind, and then gross body of panchabhuta. So every living entity in this material world is covered with these things. And as far as these things are concerned, they are completely driven by the three modes of material nature, the yantra. So what Prabhupada is pointing out is that the modern idea that a man's intelligence is limited to what is encoded in the brain is limited to what is encoded in the brain cannot be true, because behind intelligence there is this chittam, consciousness, which drives intelligence itself, and then it drives the brain. Intelligence drives the brain. The subtle body drives the brain. So intelligence, the scientists do not know about this material element called mind. They are not aware of the material element called intelligence. They are not aware of the material element called ego. They say you are egoistic, they say. But they don't say that, they don't perceive it as a energy, as a material energy. Just like if you describe, oh, you have a very strong body. You're describing the strong body. Somebody say you are egoistic, but they don't think that just like body and its quality is strong, in the same way, ego is an element with this quality of selfishness or whatever it is. So they're completely, because the modern consciousness is such that they have limited themselves to gross body. They're forced to. This is the lower guna influence, is that existence is equal to gross matter. So they themselves are gross body. So this consciousness, like Prabhupada is saying, usually normally we say subtle bodies, mind, intelligence and ego. Very important to understand this point. You go a little deeper, you will find this mind, intelligence, ego and contaminated consciousness. Then one may ask, why Krishna says only eight energies, material energy consists of eight energies. Manas, Buddhi, Ahankara and Panchabhuta. Yeah, why he doesn't say about contaminated consciousness? Because it is not a separate element. It is deposit of Manas, Buddhi and Ahankara. The accumulated Manas, Buddhi and Ahankara's activity. It is accumulation of all the activities of Manas, Buddhi and Ahankara is contaminated consciousness. Accumulate means what? Accumulated memory. At this instant, with a fresh mind and intelligence, I can see, I can do something, etc. And nothing can, even the intelligence comes from chitta. So, the content of the intelligence. We have intelligence. We have online intelligence. We have online, that means the soul has got these things. Online ego it has got. But it gets influenced by the ego, deposited ego in the chittam. That is our consciousness. In other words, you can say our subconsciousness is, subconscious mind is the chittam. It is there somewhere, no, in the memory. Just like you meet your old school friend, as soon as you see it, oh yes. Is the memory coming from the soul? No. That means within the yantra there is an arrangement. So all these impressions, not only this life, many lives, they are all sitting and it is stored. Thinking, feeling, willing, our responses, our desires, our entire life after life katha is there in the inside. And our unfulfilled desires, all those things. and the living and the soul acts through the chittam, the consciousness. So therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Cheto Dharpanam Arjanam. You have to cleanse your heart. Heart is another word for chittam. Bhakti Vinod Thakur says, heart. People say from heart, from heart, from heart. Head and heart. Heart means your consciousness body. Today you have a type of consciousness body. By your samskara you can change it into another consciousness body. That means you have to train. That's called samskara. Samskara means you have to feed into your subconscious. You have to change. Your thinking, feeling, willing has to change. Today your chittam or the contaminated consciousness or your consciousness body may be like a shudra. By samskara, you are at the root, external body you can teach samskara and all this. But ultimately that samskara means it has to go to the depth of our consciousness, which is chittam. That becomes a brahmanical consciousness. So body may be a shudra, born of a shudra, driven by a shudra brain, but the subtle body can change by samskara, and that same body can transform and act as a brahmana. Completely everything changes. Subtle influences the gross. You can change the gross from the subtle. Subtle drives the gross. So therefore here chittam, Daksha, his head was cut off, but his consciousness is with his consciousness. And he's got a goat's head, act through the goat's head. But his chittam was intact because they were very powerful living entities. Daksha is not an ordinary person. he's a Prajapati. Very powerful personalities. So chittam could act exactly like before. So this entire understanding that the brain substance is the only intelligence is not supported by this particular episode. Therefore, it is definitely concluded that brain substance is not the center of intelligence. It may be not center of intelligence, it may be somewhere in the chain, somewhere that is involved. Because if you take the brain today, you can see there is one portion of the brain which deals with rational intelligence. There is another portion which reaches with emotional intelligence. There is another portion which deals with intuition. There are different sections of the brain. And if you remove that rational section of the brain, then the person cannot be rational anymore. He cannot rationally think. Because they are all, normal living entities are completely bonded to material body. When one becomes more and more sattvic, then he identifies with his chittam. Everybody acts through the chittam. But identification is with the chittam. You see the difference between that? Even in the material world, people who are entrapped in this body, concept of life, bodily concept of life, itself has got different finer levels. In one level, it is just like animal. It has nothing, it knows nothing but its body. But among the 4 lakh species of human, if you see, as you go up, sattvic, they don't their desires are centered around the body, but they are not bodily conscious. They're not bodily conscious because their chittam is I am this body. So they have got higher levels of rasa. Even in ordinary you know people, let us say there is an intellectual discussion on something. It's at the chittam level. You are not conscious of each other's body. You are absorbed in the subject. Animals cannot do this. Here we are absorbed in that concept. The chittam, people say, if we say that, you know, man is like fire and woman is like, or man is like butter, woman is like fire, then it should melt. Everywhere you don't see it melting. They're all working. So many men and women are working. If they are at the chittam level, it just gross bodily thing is not coming so much. Finer rasa is, ego rasa is there, yes. Ego rasa is there. Female friend, male friend, girlfriend. So that ego rasa is there. A gross body rasa, culturally there will be restrictions. If a person is going cultured, that means chittam, then he will control himself, restrict himself, he will not like. Oh, I am married person, I have wife. Culturally there is good, you know, his chittam is, so he will not, gross he doesn't want. So varieties of levels of consciousness, everything cannot be reduced to only gross, even in the material world, even in material consciousness. 84 lakh species out of like 4 lakh human species means 4 lakh different levels of contaminated consciousness is there, from animal to demigod. A demigod, very subtle is their rasa. A chittam level is their rasa. And then you come down closer, human, or, you know, lower rungs of consciousness, it comes to only eating, sleeping, mating, defending. The whole focus, goal of life is to eat, sleep, mate and defend. But goal of life of everybody is not that in the material world. A rich man, eating, sleeping, mating, defending, easily comes. What does he want? He wants finer chittam. His consciousness needs name, fame, success. He is working for that. He even neglects eating, sleeping also. He is all after that. So the contaminated consciousness, the whole consciousness, contaminated consciousness, common feature is not eating, sleeping, mating, defending. Common feature is lording nature, lording rasa. Wants to lord over the material energy, wants independence. So, let's read some Prabhupada's conversation. Where Prabhupada, life comes from life. Prabhupada says, all matter is combination of 5 elements, earth, water, fire, air, ether. And 3 subtle elements, mind, intelligence and false ego. Okay? So now you accommodated chittam. We know that it is not an 8th element, but it is deposit of these 3 elements. See, just like gross body, no? Gross food I take, it goes into my body. When I am a baby, I am fed. That turns out to become my body. As I grow, I will use my own gross body. I will use my hand, take on gross food, put in my stomach. It gets processed. some part of it becomes my body. Okay. So my own action is deposited and it becomes my body. Similarly, my own thinking, feeling and willing history is captured as a memory, experiential memory, and that is the consciousness body or the chittam. That is the meaning of where is that personality coming from? Okay, thinking, feeling, willing. But you have a personality each time, you have a personality, isn't it? Your personality is different, your personality is different, personality is different. It's not only the physical personality, your inner personality is different. That personality is the chittam, that is the heart. So purification of heart means that personality, that chittam, that personality should become a pure Vaishnava. Devotee, according to Vedic science, material energy begins with false ego and then develops intelligence, then mind, and then gross elements, ether, air, fire, and so on. So the same basic ingredients are present in all matter. Is that right? Prabhupada, yes. The creation of the material universe is like the growth of a great banyan tree from a tiny seed. No one can see the tree within the seed, but all necessary ingredients for the tree are already there, including the required intelligence. Actually, everyone's body is simply a universe, sample universe. Your body and my body are different universes, small universes. Therefore, all eight material elements are present within our body, just as they are within the whole universe. Similarly, an insect's body is another universe. Devotee, how about the atom? Srila Prabhupada, the same formula applies. All these constituents are within the atom. Anor aniyan mohoto mahiyan. This means that whether something is extremely large or infinitesimal, it is still made of the same basic elements. This is true everywhere in the material world. Just as a woman's small watch has all the requisite machinery for its smooth functioning, so an ant has all the necessary brain substance to manage its affairs nicely. How is this possible? To answer this properly, you must minutely examine the brain tissues in the ant. But this you cannot do. Moreover, there are innumerable insects smaller than ant. So there must be a mechanical arrangement for all this detailed activity. But the scientists cannot discover it. Srila Prabhupada, all living entities possess the required intelligence to execute four principles: eating, sleeping, sexual intercourse, and defense. These four principles exist even in atom. The only difference in the human being is that he has extra intelligence with which to understand God. That is the difference. Ahara nidra bhaya maitunam cha samantam etat pashubhir niranam naranam. Eating, sleeping, sex life, defense are to be found everywhere. You have seen trees growing. Wherever there is a knot, the bark does not go that way. It goes that way. Srila Prabhupada gestures to show that the tree's bark grows not over the knot but around it. The tree has intelligence. If I go this way, I'll be blocked. So I'll go that way. Very interesting. The tree has intelligence. This way I'll be blocked. So I will go that way. But where are its eyes? How can it see? No, it has intelligence. That intelligence may not be as good as yours, but it is intelligence. Similarly, a child also has intelligence, though not as developed as father's. In due course of time, when the child gets a body like that of his father, the child's intelligence will be fully developed and exhibited. It doesn't matter what kind of brain one has, because if he simply transfers his consciousness from matter to Krishna, his life becomes successful. Devotee, once we were walking and saw a patch of yellow grass. In his famous way, Srila Prabhupada stopped, pointed to this patch of yellow grass and said, "Why is this grass yellow when all other grass is green?" Gurudas offered some practical reasons: because of the nature of the soil, because of too much rain, and so forth. Srila Prabhupada said, "No, this grass is yellow because it is detached from the root. All plants get their nourishment from their roots. As soon as they are detached from the roots, there is difficulty. Similarly, we are in difficulty in this material world because we have become detached from Krishna. As soon as we are attached to Krishna, our life becomes successful." It's a beautiful example. It's confirmed by Lord Krishna himself in the Bhagavad Gita that anyone who takes up Krishna consciousness achieves the highest perfection of life, regardless of whatever abominable condition of life he may have fallen into. Specifically, anyone in Krishna consciousness goes back to Godhead, back to home on leaving his present material body. That's how powerful it is, Krishna consciousness, chanting. Devotee, one time in India, while Srila Prabhupada was staying in Mayapur, two of the Prabhupada's western-born sannyasis visited a temple and heard an odd comment from a pujari. When Srila Prabhupada's men were taking darshan of deities, the pujari seemed to appreciate their reverence and demeanor. And he says, "Continue to render devotional service," the pujari brahmana advised them, "and maybe in your next life you'll be born as a brahmana." The disciples later went to Srila Prabhupada and told him of the incident. Prabhupada smiled and told a story. Once there was an old lady who lived in a remote village. One day the British district magistrates visited her town. This old lady has been entangled in a quarrel regarding possession of land, which some of her relatives were trying to take from her. Friends advised that she see the magistrate and present the matter to him for settlement. When she did so, the magistrate immediately ruled in her favor, made sure the land was put in her name. Delighted, the old lady attempted to bless the magistrate. "I bless you," she said, "that in your next life, you will become a police constable." In the old lady's mind, Srila Prabhupada explained, the office of the police constable was the highest thing she could imagine. Similarly, said Srila Prabhupada, these caste brahmanas do not know that pure devotional service is much higher than being born as a brahmana. After Bhagavatam class, Srila Prabhupada had all the beads draped over the side of Vyasasan, and his servant Nanda Kumar started to call us one by one to receive the beads and our spiritual names. There was one boy who had been a butcher before, and apparently Prabhupada had been informed about it. After the candidate had repeated the last regulative principles, no meat eating, fish or eggs, there is a moment of silence. Prabhupada looked at his prospective disciple gravely and said, "Please don't kill any more cows." The boy blushed and simply shook his head in embarrassment. And then Prabhupada gave him the name Maharati Dasa, the servant of one who can fight with 1,000 enemies at a time. We were all amazed at Srila Prabhupada's extraordinary mercy and compassion, considering that cow killing is one of the most sinful acts for which the culprit has to be born in the body of a cow and be slaughtered as many times as there are hairs on the cow's skin. It is remarkable that Srila Prabhupada never hesitated to accept even such a person as a disciple, provided he agreed to give up his sinful ways. In this way, he acted as a perfect representative of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who accepted even sinners like Jagai and Madai on the condition that they would not commit any more sinful activities. Srila Prabhupada ki, Gandharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Any questions? Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Just now you said about samskara, we can change the consciousness of the body of a person. So in this context, I just want to understand how important...
Not consciousness of the body.
Of the person.
Of the person.
Of the person.
Chitta.
Yeah. Chitta. So how effective the... important the samskara is. So as a case study, if you take a child, a newly born child, not knowing to which family the child was born in, and if you try to groom the child into a Krishna conscious aspect, I mean the samskara, so will the child take it up?
Yeah.
So the birth is not a factor.
It's a fact, but not everything you cannot change. If you have spiritual power, you can change, like Daksha. If you are an evolved person.
But the process of our Krishna conscious process is very defined.
Our process, yes. In our process, we can.
Yeah, defined.
In our process, we can. Provided our process is taken properly. Administered properly. One who chants nicely, hears nicely, he can overcome his old samskaras like anything. Old samskara is nothing but old habits. Old habits will just die away. How many old habits we have given up? Right? Our friends in the college and all, they'll say, how you can live here without all this? Isn't it? How you can live? You must be suffering. We are not suffering.
So the birth is not a factor of which family the baby is born or the child is born.
It is a factor. It's a gross factor.
Gross.
Okay? Then there is a subtle factor. By association you can change. How does samskara change? Subtle body association. How do we get Vaishnava samskara? By Vaishnava association. Living with the Vaishnavas, you are two devotees. You cannot talk like a karmi to him after joining. Right? He will not appreciate. So then you are forced to talk to him like a Vaishnava. Deal with him like a Vaishnava. So Sangha. When you associate, the samskara changes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Prabhu, you told about the change of subtle body. So my question is about the, you have also mentioned in one of your modules that the present is, the existence of the soul should be in the present. But because the soul generates attention energy, the mind transports the attention energy to the past and the future.
To the past in his mind.
In his mind. So it is. So the soul is an existential being. So it experiences through mind. Correct. So how is it happening that it is getting transported to the past and future? Means it doesn't exist, right? Past and future.
Transported within the mind, no. There's nothing like past and future, no. Only present is there. Yesterday was a present. Tomorrow will be a present. Is it not? We read that as past and present. So when we try, right now, what is the reality? Current is a reality. Isn't it? The present is a reality. Now, with my mind, I can think of yesterday. And I tend to think that yesterday is, when I go back, I think it is a reality. It doesn't exist. It's in your head. Where does it exist?
It'll
be a memory.
Yes, but we do calculations for future, in our service also. For future, we do calculation based on, means in
right.
Present, we do calculation
right.
For future. Right.
Right.
So if it doesn't exist, then why we have to...
No, 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 it doesn't exist. Now I am thinking a VK Hill temple should be completed. Right? May get completed, may not get completed. That is a reality. But in my mind, I will go and say I have to complete in the next few years, I should complete. Yeah. Will it happen or not? Because this desire for completion is where? In the head. In the head, I will see it completed also. Does it mean that it is future? No. Future is future. When it comes, you will see. What happens 2022, you will see. Whether it is there or not. Independent of what is in my head.
So the difference between Jiva Bhuta and Brahma Bhuta is Brahma Bhuta will be always in the present as you told. And Jiva Bhuta keeps on shifting from past to future based on mental concoction. Is it so, Prabhu? I mean, projection.
Yes, conditioned souls, they think like this. They live in, they are trapped in this material time. Brahma Bhuta means they transcend the material time and they know that they are eternal, Krishna is eternal, life is eternal, everything. That is Brahma Bhuta.
Prabhu, one more question, Prabhu. So, Chittam is not a layer, Prabhu, as you told. Chittam, contaminated consciousness, not a separate layer. That's why Krishna didn't mention.
No, it is a layer.
But is it a seamless
layer?
Building?
It is not a separate element.
Okay.
Manas, see, immediate what is covering the soul is your memories, Chittam. This Chittam itself is using the Manas, Buddhi and Ahankara. Today, how you use your manas depends on what? Today, the muscular bicep strength of mine depends on past what all I fed to the gross body. Isn't it? It is a result of that. So, this much is deposited around me. Similarly, there are thoughts, there are impressions, all these things are deposited. But that's all. We should, whenever old habits come, we should. If you understand this, you can clearly, if you can clearly see that that is not me, that is the old me acting memory, it's not me, then you won't be sympathetic with it. You are thinking that is also me, this is also me, that's also me, future also me. So how can I deny the desire of that? It is my desire. If what is your current desire, you should have high value. Today I am Krishna conscious. This is my real desire. Desires in my past, my past personality, different desires that I had, that are not my desire, they are the memories. So immediately once that reality is taken away from that, it diffuses. And there is value for what you desire now.
So is this Chittam a seamless welding between matter and spirit?
Huh?
Is it a seamless welding between matter and spirit? This Chittam, is it a seamless welding which you had mentioned in one of your lectures? Is it a seamless welding between matter and spirit?
No, it's not matter. Spirit is different, matter is different. It's an immediate neighbor. The spirit radiates consciousness. That consciousness becomes, interacts with material nature, becomes experience. That experience deposits. But always spirit is Kshetrajna, is separate from conscious Chittam.
But what is that seamless welding you told? Once you use this term called seamless welding, is it related to false ego, which is the...
No. This whole entire system, they are different elements. Chittam is different. Manas, Buddhi, Ahankara, actually they are different function. Hand is different. Leg is different. But they are all like, we take it as one. Gross body, subtle body, all together. So in reality, there are 8 elements. You could actually separate them and throw them in different direction. You can take a watch, take all the wheels and throw them in different direction. Watch is not there. Right? The reality is they're all individual. So similarly, it's a heterogeneous mixture of 8 elements put together. Doesn't look like it looks like an I am. Like a self.
Final question, Prabhu, last question. So, the demigods enjoy subtlest material rasa. So, what about the position of Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva? Because in many places in Bhagavatam, it is told that although they take care of the modes, they are not infected by the modes.
Hmm.
So they don't enjoy the subtlest rasa, means if there are various
depends.
Degrees.
The demigod, if this Brahma's post is a post, according to purity of that soul, his rasa will be different. If he is a pure devotee, then he will not have rasa, that rasa. If he is not a pure devotee, he will have rasa. Shiva is different. Shiva's because he is a Vaishnava, he is always absorbed in meditation on Vishnu. So he is free from material rasas. Demigods are not free from material rasas.